In this video, we are going to talk about the different methods of performing a backup of your PyData archive, as well as the components of a comprehensive backup strategy. In general, in your Py system, you have users connect to your PyData archive to retrieve historical or real-time time series data. You may have previously heard the PyData archive referred to as the Py server. In general, a backup is a copy of your information in case the original is damaged or lost. When it comes to your PyData archive, a backup is a copy of both your data or your archive files themselves, as well as the configuration information that is necessary to restore your PyData archive to its exact customized configuration. A backup works such that you copy your configuration information and data to a specified location, which can then be used to restore your system on a new machine. Let's take a look in more detail at what this entails. In my PyData archive, I have several components that are important and custom to my configuration. For instance, I have my PyData archive installation directory itself, which holds all the configuration information for my system. I also have a directory of my archive files, which is where my time series data is stored. Finally, I have my client directories, including the configuration of interfaces that are installed locally on my PyData archive. I want to save all of these particular settings on my system in order to restore it at a future point. Therefore, we recommend taking a backup of our PyData archive, where we will copy all of these files and store them in a separate specified location. In order to minimize the impact on the performance of our running PyData archive during the backup process, we recommend using a script provided with your PyData archive installation to perform a backup locally on the PyData archive first. We will then also talk about saving a copy of these files in a remote location as well. On our PyData archive itself, we recommend performing a backup and saving the files on a dedicated disk drive. For instance, if my PyData archive is installed on my C drive and my archive files are held on my D drive, then if I stored my backup on either my C or my D drive, I would have no protection in the case of disk failure on either of those drives, as I would lose both the original files and backups. However, if I have my backup stored on the dedicated disk drive, I know in the event of disk failure in either of the drives that holds my PyData archive or my archive files themselves, I'll still have a safe copy of my data on my dedicated drive for my backups. However, you may also encounter a situation where there isn't just disk failure on a particular drive. You may experience hardware failure on the entire PyData archive machine itself. In this case, even though our backups are on a dedicated drive, we will also lose our backup files as they are on the same machine. For situations like this, we recommend including in your comprehensive backup strategy a remote backup of your PyData archive. This can be done on a remote medium, such as another computer, disk, or any other storage device. We recommend you work with your IT department to include this local backup directory as part of your full backup strategy. However, if your IT department is unavailable to help with this, there is a script included with your PyData archive installation that can be configured to perform the remote backup as well. In this case, the same configuration information and files will be copied to a remote medium. That way, if there is a hardware failure on the PyData archive machine itself, we will be able to restore our system on a new machine using the files from a remote backup location. However, going through the process of taking a local backup on our PyData archive, as well as copying that local backup directory to a remote medium, sounds like a tedious process to perform habitually. Therefore, we have included a method of creating a scheduled automated task to perform this entire backup procedure for you. However, if the automated task runs and copies the entire PyData archive directory and all of your archive files themselves every time it runs, it is performing a lot more work than it needs to. For this reason, the automated PyData archive backups are known as what is type incremental. This means they will only include files that have been modified since the last automated backup was performed. These files will be updated in the local backup directory as well as forwarded to your remote backup location. When it comes to your remote backup, you have two choices for its configuration if using the script provided with the PyData archive to perform the remote backup. You can have the same backup directory copied every time, having it overwrite itself, thus only keeping the most recent backup of your PyData archive. or you can create what is known as a repository of backups, where you keep backups from different points in time. Here, for instance, I have a backup from March 1st, 2015, as well as a backup from March 7th, 2015. By creating a repository, you can see that I have different restore points for my PyData archive. For instance, if there was nothing wrong with my PyData archive at the time of the most recent backup, I can use the most recent backup to restore my PyData archive if necessary. On the other hand, if I realize I made a configuration change or deleted certain components of my PyData archive that I shouldn't have, I can use an older backup, such as the one from March 1st, to restore my PyData archive, as long as it was taken before the configuration change or deletion occurred. This local and remote backup procedure via automated task is part of our recommended comprehensive backup strategy for your PyData archive. However, we recognize there may be times outside of this regularly scheduled backup process that you would like to take a backup. For instance, if I'm on the phone with a tech support engineer performing certain troubleshooting or testing steps, they may request we take a backup of the PyData archive right then. In situations like this, you can perform what is known as an on-demand backup. Here you can specify a subset or all files in your PyData archive to be copied and backed up to a particular location that you can then use to restore your system on a new machine. This on-demand backup can be easily performed through a plugin to PySystem Management Tools. It is important to also note that this on-demand backup will not interfere with your regularly scheduled automated backups. Overall, a full backup strategy will include taking a local backup of your PyData archive on a dedicated disk drive. This backup should include both your archive files, as well as the configuration information that is specific to your PyData archive. Then your backup strategy should include copying the local backup directory to a remote medium, ideally creating a repository of different backups from your PyData archive over time. For more information, please check out the following videos to learn more about how to configure an automated backup task, as well as perform an on-demand backup.